The endangered western pond turtle, found along the Pacific coast, has been a focus of a collaborative reintroduction effort for more than 25 years. The Washington Department of Fish and Wildlife, AZA partners at Woodland Park Zoo, Oregon Zoo, and others have been working to give turtles a head start by raising them in human care and releasing them, helping to boost wild populations in an attempt to save these animals from extinction. As a result of these efforts, the turtle population in Washington has grown from as few as 150 in the early 1990s to more than 1,000 at 6 sites. This is a significant step toward recovery of the species, helping to target them before it's on the brink of extinction. Recently, however, a shell disease has been detected in Washington's wild turtle population and appears to be increasing. Work is currently being done by the University of Illinois Zoological Pathology Program to better understand what causes turtles to become sick. Shedd Aquarium's Microbiome Project has also joined this conservation effort. Shedd's new laboratory will use DNA sequencing to identify microbes that could be beneficial for the turtles in the Head Start environment, giving their caretakers another tool to help save this endangered species. We're interested in learning as much as we can about the natural environments that these turtles inhabit. We'd like to know what the microbial communities look like in different parts of the habitat. So we're taking samples of the water, and we're taking samples of what we call biofilm, which is an accumulation of microorganisms that grows on surfaces in the pond habitat. We're sampling some of the locations where we know the turtles like to bask. This will give us an idea of a different group of microbes they might be interacting with. The Microbiome Project has a tremendous resource in the 32,000 animals that live at Shedd. When we care for animals in a managed environment, we know what temperature to keep them at, we know what salinity to have of the water, we know what kind of substrate they like to climb on, how much water they need. What we don't know is what kind of microbiome we should be encouraging in those habitats to produce the best outcomes for health for these animals. We're asking that question now for the western pond turtle and the animals that are head started. How can we manage the microbiome of the Head Start environment to best prepare the turtles for success when they're released back into the wild?
The stage we're at right now is trying to identify what is this disease, why do they have it, what causes it, can we treat it? We don't know the answers to any of those questions yet.
Working with our partners, one of the end results we're hoping to accomplish is determine what's causing the fungal shell disease and what can we do about it. So by collecting these samples in the field, we're going to be able to determine what the normal microbiota is and compare it to what we're finding in more of a zoo and aquarium setting to hopefully adjust a little bit how we're raising these turtles, how we're releasing them. Shedd Aquarium is in a unique position to help with these sort of projects because we can take the work that we've been doing, fine-tuning how we care for some of these animals, and again, take that information we learn at the aquarium and apply it to ones in the field to make sure that they're healthy and able to survive for future generations.
Anytime you want to do something as ambitious as save a species, it's going to take more than one partner or more than one agency to do it. There's regulatory folks involved, there's field biologists. Where I think it really works well for us is these partnerships allow us to do what we do best, which is care for animals in this setting. And so by partnering with people who have different kinds of specialization, different kinds of expertise, we all collectively bring our best to the large and complex problem of what's going on with western pond turtles.
There's not a lot of turtle diversity in the western part of the United States, and so this turtle is critically important because it does play a unique role in the ecosystem. And once the turtle's gone, I'm sure will have widespread effects on ecosystem health.
Oftentimes, reptiles and amphibians tend to be a little misunderstood. People don't always care about them as much, but they are important links in the web of life and important for a lot of the ecosystems that they survive in. Western pond turtles actually eat a lot of aquatic vegetation, so help provide areas for fish to breed, for aquatic insects to live, for newts to come and lay their eggs, for toads to come down and breed. So we have to kind of help out all these species. Even though we may be working with one, it's going to affect all the animals that call these ponds home up in the Pacific Northwest.